not appreciate the will and the intent of the Indian political establishment and the Indian armed forces, that they will never allow them to succeed. And no matter what heights they capture, the Indian army will always get back to them and recapture those heights. And this was evident during the Kargil war in 1999. So I would rather him not dare any such attempt in the future. Today we have got also better surveillance devices. But other than that, we are sitting on those heights where he thinks he can come. But the end state of Kargil has been that we have ensured that he also better remain alert sitting opposite us, because we are also capable of undertaking such missions. But we will only take such missions when we are reasonably sure of success. I am not saying that we always plan for 100% success. We do take risks, and that the commanders are expected to take some risks. But he better not attempt such a thing in the future. You know what has been happening on the line of control in other places. We have put him on the back foot, and we will continue putting him on the back foot. And my warning to Pakistan is, do not ever attempt such a misadventure anytime in the future, anywhere, anytime. Do not think of it.
Imran Khan has yesterday given a statement. Imran Khan has given a statement where he's saying he's trying to portray Pulwama bombing as an indigenous effort, where he's trying to shrug off the shoulder that Pakistan is having no hand in that. How do you react to this statement where he says that he was indigenous person who was radicalized in Kashmir Valley and Jaish is operating on Indian side and Pakistan ka naam to aise hi aa gaya? So how you react to that?
We are aware of the truth, so we don't have to get carried away by any statement. The truth is known to us and our establishment. Our intelligence agencies have given ample proof of what had happened in Pulwama, and that is all I would like to say.
Sir, yesterday Army displayed a lot of Make in India weapons. Is there a thrust going to be Army in Kargil to produce and use Make in India weapons as well?
No, making in Kargil you are trying to say?
No, make in India.
No, Make in India thrust has already commenced. In fact, you see, the guns are being manufactured in India. We've got modern 155mm guns being made in India. The helicopters are made in India. We're also looking at manufacturing ammunition here in the country. And now the AK-203 in a joint venture with Russia is going to be manufactured in Amethi in India. So an impetus is being given to Make in India. And we will only be very happy if anybody is willing to share technology with us and collaborate with us. I would say that they would be the gainers, because we have a huge market here, and once any weapon that is tested by the Indian Army, it becomes world famous, because everybody knows our testing and trial mechanisms are very good. So any weapon which gets introduced in the Indian Army, any other world army will be willing to take.
After Balakot strike, infiltration has come down. You think that we had somewhere succeeded in breaking backbone of Pakistan to an extent and sent a very strong message to them?
Infiltration has come down because of two reasons. One is because our troops are sitting alert. We have also inducted additional forces to strengthen the counter-infiltration grid. So the Pakistan Army and the terrorists across understand that if they come anywhere near the line of control, they will only have to come back to recover dead bodies. So infiltration is coming down because of our actions.